Hello and welcome back to Twiggy, where the order of the day is more DIY. Inevitably, that's going to be the case for quite a while. But other than pulling down the remainder of the carpet, which still needs to be done, I think what I really need to do is quite a lot of measurements, because if I'm going to put a tambour door on the cupboards, I need to know how tall and wide that is. If I'm going to fit a battery in there and solar charge controller, those kind of things, I just need to take a lot of measurements so I know how big each of the storage compartments are, the cupboards, and then I can properly work out where things are going to go. Under here, for example, I am thinking of not only tucking the battery in there, and there is plenty of space for it, I'll put a baseboard down and then a battery, possibly in one of those little plastic battery boxes, and there should be space to put a solar charge controller and even conceivably an inverter as well, although I haven't quite worked out where that's going. I'm not sure if I'm going to bother with that, but I will still need a battery. And then I do want a fridge. I know some people have said, what about a cool box? But I think it's important to have properly chilled refreshments. So this space, which does have scope for actually cutting it back a bit and making it a bit wider, not a lot, but a bit, I want to see if I can find a little mini fridge or possibly a fridge on rollers that I can pull out, you know, make a little board for it and then pull it out, fridge. I need to slightly work out where, if you were going to do any catering, would you be on your hands and knees here facing this, or would you sit on the chair here and prefer to have everything rotate out at you? I'm not sure. It's never going to be big culinary exercises carried out here, but anyway, let's do some measuring. So the gap as it stands is 51.5 centimetres. Let's write that down. Something else I'm just wondering, this is the space underneath where the driver's feet sit. So you're in the centre cockpit area here, out of the main cabin, and under here is sufficient space for a standard sized battery. You've got 330mm back, you've got 240mm floor to ceiling, and you've got plenty of depth, about 40 centimetres that way. So you could get a battery in here, not in a battery box. I don't think there'd be sufficient height, not without changing this not particularly attractive floor thing. It's not out of the realms of possibility. However, the battery could go here in the centre cockpit. The only downside being, of course, that if the canopy is not up, you run the risk of rain, but on the other hand, it is under this floor piece, and you could make that watertight. So I'm pondering that. That might be a terrible idea, but I'm willing to entertain opinions on that, if anyone has any, to voice. Hello. And that would mean the battery wouldn't be in the cabin. Same again, under where any passenger sits. There is this big space, and it is raised up off the floor by a couple of inches, and it is covered, so you could conceivably make that a battery space. I think I prefer having the battery in the cabin if that is feasible, but it does give me options. Something else I want to measure up is the floor of the centre cockpit, as I'm going to put down some of that rubberized kind of matting, just to give it a bit of a nicer look, I think. Right, I've measured the port side cupboard. I suspect this one, where the batteries are, is much the same. Of course, you have got the sink. So depth is, roughly speaking, well, because it's curved, or sloped, you've got 44 centimetres here. Now, without touching the battery terminals, how much have we got at the back? I also can't actually tell at floor level because the batteries are in the way. However, 45 front to back here. And at the level of the stringer, which I can just see, 43. So let's call that 43. And I can't measure floor level with that because the batteries are in the way. Oh, does this mean I'm going to end up taking the batteries out? I wasn't planning on that today, but maybe.
What I'm thinking is that I could either have a kind of flat but full length water tank up to where the outlet of the sink goes, or if I kept it over to that side, it could actually be a tall and thin water tank. I suppose I need to do some googling of water tanks and see what convenient sizes are available.
This bit of carpet has to go. I like having a bit of carpet in here, keeps it nice and warm, but it's not well fitted at all. If we look down the edge here, I mean, that is not well cut and it's all fraying. It hasn't got a proper edge to it, and it's not very well fitted round that. So although somebody's had a go at it, and it's actually running slightly up the wall on that side, whereas it's not quite to the wall on that side. So that is going to come out. There's some underlay underneath it, which I may keep. Someone's glued it to the underlay. Now you'd think I'd keep this bit as a template, but in fact, because it doesn't quite fit properly, it won't be a good template. So I think I will just scrap it and make a new template. Although I suppose I could use that as a starting point, if out of cardboard or something, and then trim the starting point. So maybe I won't throw that. Right. Park that there for the moment. The underlay appears to have been glued down. Also not brilliantly cut. A little bit of trimming would sort that. I might leave that in. No harm in it, I don't think. Give it a bit of extra trim around here. Around the table leg holder. Yeah, I'll leave that in for the moment. Right, let's get on with removing the roof carpet, which is partly why I'm here. Now, where I was up to on this is, I think, that there was one more screw to come out there, and I can't see any others. That one's out. So I think anything else holding this in is just glue. And someone in the comments has reminded me of the word I was looking for when talking about the wood board. And this is hardboard. It is a piece of hardboard, which is not terribly hard at all, and will be replaced. I'm pondering various things about the replacement. Some people have said put slats of wood in, but I always think that looks a bit like a sauna, and I'm not a huge fan of that look. So I don't think I'll go for that, but I have got a few ideas. I'm idly wondering whether, if you cast your mind back a long time to when I did my shower refurb on the narrowboat, the video was called A Night on the Tiles, and I used a sort of plastic stuff for the walls, and I'm wondering whether that could be adapted for the ceiling. It's just sheets of flat corrugated plastic designed for showers, but I'm wondering whether that would work stuck up there. Although this is a slightly funny shape, it's all a bit contoured. Which could explain why they've used a bit of hardboard. Anyway, let's see when I pull this out. Oh, lots of glue. Lots of expanding foam, which is being used as glue. Come on. I think that's the only thing holding it up. No other screws, are there? Oh, no. Ah, okay. Right, let's just be violent. There we go. That is... Oh, I see. The carpet, hello. The carpet extends beyond the hardboard. So, hang on. What's that dangling on? Oh, it does go under this other bit. I wondered if it went under here, and it does. Well, what's holding this bit up? More screws, I think, and more sticky gunge.
Screw on that, I can come off the more of that LED lighting. Wrapping around like that. There we go. There we go.
A few folks have said I might come to regret this. Come on. As if that would ever happen.
Not all that.
Come on. Oh, it's just masses of sticky foam and one of the wires to the navigation lights. Down you come, down you come. Oh my goodness. Right, yeah, there's the LED lights. They can go over there. It's like some sort of cloud city up there.
Look, it's like we've entered a new
place full of fluffy clouds. And that's the block of wood. Can you see that one? Yes, you can, I think. That's the block of wood that goes into the fiberglass above. Ooh, I don't like this expanding foam stuff. It's obviously very sticky, but I'm not a fan. That's the navigation light. Stuck in again with lots of sticky gunge. This can't be an official way to build boats with expanding foam, surely. That's not, and that's a horrid, horrid junction of those wires. Look at that, the two bits for the navigation lights just gaffer taped together. I think what I need for scraping these off is a flat putty knife that I can just go underneath them with, because some bits are coming off and then some bits are so well stuck, I need to go underneath them. And then this is the actual fiberglass of the boat. So we'll scrape all that lot off and just take it back to its bare shell. These curtain rail things, twangy, stretchy things, are hooked round these screws, which have an unscrewable end. So then that can just come off. In case you're wondering, yes, I do sometimes wonder what the heck I'm doing. There's the carpet, there's the ceiling, as was. And there are the bits of carpet that I've been pulling off so far. The front cabin decarpeted. Well, I think that will do for today. There it is, all stripped out. There is a little bit of water over there coming down that seam, and it doesn't seem to be coming from the anchor locker, so it could be condensation, hard to tell. It's just a tiny bit damp. And then here's all this carpet that I now need to remove and take down the tip. And I think that is enough for a morning. Frankly, stripping out this front cabin, especially as I've now got to go and dispose of all this stuff. So that will do for this one, I think. Cheerio.